Well, I'm here with my longtime, I won't say how longtime, friend Cindy Jacobs.
Yes.
And I want to talk to you today about how original artwork gets translated into products that you see on the shelf. Because mm-hmm. for every product you see on the shelves in the store mm-hmm. with images on them, mm-hmm. you always know that there was somebody long before that process happened that was doing original art. Mm-hmm. Some people do it with a paintbrush, some people do it with a computer, but my friend Cindy does a lot of different media and probably best known for her watercolor. Mm-hmm. And that's where it all starts. So we're gonna start with this piece of artwork.
Yes.
Alrighty.
And that is some daisies in some white ball jars. And this has been a really popular piece. So the hand watercolor is done first, and that's what this is. This is the original hand-painted watercolor, and that might take me a whole day to paint.
Only a day.
Well, sometimes I can do two or three in a day. Right, right. It depends on how detailed they are, but you can see this one has a lot of detail, and painting the ball jar and perfect mason and all that takes some time. So then after that is painted, I will scan it on my scanner, and then voila, it's in my computer.
Now it's electronic format.
Yes.
Okay, on something like this, Cindy, do you paint just out of your head?
Well,
or do you line up some jars, or do you take a photo of something you like, and what's your inspiration?
Sometimes it's photos. Sometimes it's photos that I take myself, or sometimes I'll ask somebody to use a photo, or sometimes I'll use the floral out of one photo and use the ball jars out of another floral. But I do a lot of florals in my own house. So sometimes I take pictures myself and use those as inspiration. So that's a very good question. So once it's in the computer, then I can manipulate it all I want. Sometimes I'll cut out the floral and then that makes it a little clip art, and then I can put it with something else. Or sometimes I'll cut out the ball jar in Photoshop and then I can put that with something else. So there's some samples over there to your left, Betty.
Yeah.
Some different things.
So let's see, we're looking at this one.
Yep,
so
at the daisy.
It could be this one, which is totally different, brighter, and mm-hmm. as you can see, a lot of detail cut out. So uh-huh. how did that get born?
This one is just part of those daisies, and then I made a separate ball jar, and they didn't want the ball part on there, so we just made it plain. And then this was produced by a company called Studio M, and they made this into a door hanger. And Studio M also manufactures these garden flags. So they also put it on a flag, and this is a different company. They put it on some placemats. And then another.
I'm sitting on a rug.
Yes, you are. You're cutting up a rug.
I am cutting a rug.
So, and then this is a doormat made out of the same artwork. So the one piece of original artwork has probably been on 20 to 25 different products, which is very exciting.
So how this works is that you contract with a company that purchases your images
right.
from you.
Right.
And some of them you've manipulated. Uh-huh. Some of them they manipulate,
yes.
and then they put it on the market for various manufacturers. Is that right?
That is right.
So who does this beautiful little tea towel?
That is Audrey's Your Heart's Delight.
Tell me about the lettering. Did you do that, or did they add the lettering?
I added the lettering, sometimes I use a font for the lettering, and sometimes I do hand lettering. And the hand lettering obviously takes a lot more time. And then Audrey's Your Heart's Delight put one also. They used this other artwork. Yep. And
let me show them the other artwork.
Yep. And they put that on a tea towel like this.
Kind of twiggy and delicate that is. And probably this design might scan, let's say, different styles of decor.
Right.
This one might trend to maybe more contemporary, where the one with the ball jars would have a more farmhouse feel.
Right, right. Kind of a country. Right. See, and then they put it on that pillow as well.
And added some lettering.
And added the lettering. And
today
I did
everything
do.
Must have lettering.
I know. But, you know, back in the day when I used to manufacture the scissor cuts and we had those long verses, and people would actually take time to stand there and read. Sometimes I would see them crying
I did that.
Over guilty. Verses and different yeah. things. Mm-hmm. But nowadays, people are so busy, they don't want to stand there and read the long, long verse. Mm-hmm. They want it to say something kind of short. They still want it to be maybe a little bit sappy.
Meaningful, but pithy.
But short. Yeah.
And yeah. I
to
know
the point.
You see that little TL colon DR, which stands for too long, didn't read.
Oh,
people,
okay.
People sometimes, we're all pressed for time.
I know. So anyway, that turned out really cute. And then if you want to pull out that original behind there, this was a whole year ago in January. So it would have been January of 2020. My publisher took this to a show, I think in California, and he texted me and he's like, I'm really excited because Hobby Lobby just loves all your new pieces. So you can see it's taken a long time, but this was transformed into that front one there.
These little guys?
Nope, the next third one.
The canvas.
There you go. Yep, the canvas with the gel on it. So they manipulated the vase a little bit and put some more contemporary lines across
and
here.
And added some dimension
and then
some shine.
Yes, mm-hmm. And it has that little bit of gel and texture mm-hmm. on it. So they've ordered a lot of these. And then I took all
Can
four.
I ask a question?
Sure.
Are you seeing more trends evolving with canvases as opposed to frames?
Yes. People don't like the glassed framed artwork anymore. They like wood boards and they like the canvases.
And I can see that they would be more lightweight.
Sure.
More shippable.
Yep.
Less likely to break.
Mm-hmm.
And also a lot of people are going more to a matte finish
yes.
on a lot of things than
yes,
so
rather yeah. than glossy.
Rather than shiny.
So there were four in this set. There was roses, hydrangeas,
we had to pull this pink eye up here.
Yeah. And so we took all four of those and I scanned them and then I put them rotate clockwise.
Oh. Oh, how funny.
And now we're hiding you. You're back That's behind right. there. So here's the four different pots, and it has the gel texture on it, too. So that's very fun.
Sorry. Sorry.
You're fine. Now we get to see your beautiful face.
Yeah.
And then these other pieces
Ooh,
are also...
those have dimension.
Yeah, at Hobby Lobby. So this one, I did the artwork back here, which was just a leaf. And then it says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. And some of the artwork is printed on the glass on the front, and then some of the printing is on the back. So it makes a really neat three-dimensional piece. And I think it's this one, a little birdie told me that is one of Hobby Lobby's better sellers. Wow. So that's very fun.
You know, I may know that birdie. But what's interesting to me is the way an artist's mind works.
Mm-hmm.
Because being an artist, you don't see things just as they are.
Right.
You're always seeing things like they could be, or mm-hmm. what if I tried this, mm-hmm. or what would it look like if I did? And, you know, that's part of the creative process that I love.
Yeah, and it's part of the creative process that I don't sleep at night because I'm always thinking about something.
Yeah,
it's very fun, though, and I just love what I do. And here's those same daisies that were put on a little glass mug. So that was very fun. There you go. It's empty. Sorry. I got some eggnog in the fridge.
Eggnog? Ooh.
Yes.
All right. I love eggnog.
And then this was a really fun piece that came from this original artwork. So it was a set of three barns that I did that
were...
looks
like my house.
There you go. That were winter scenes.
Mm-hmm.
So Crown Point Graphics licensed this to put on these Christmas cards, and they're really exquisite because they have put glitter. They're kind of three-dimensional. They put artwork on the inside. They even have artwork on the back.
Wow.
And these are available on their website, a set of 30 or a set of 16.
That is a statement. When you get a card like that in the mail, you know somebody really thought about it.
Yeah. That's cool. So that's fun. And here's some other cards that Crown Point Graphics did. But sometimes they'll do artwork just for a specific chain of stores. So you can't buy these because they were made exclusively for a box chain store. And the same with these, which are fun because they have some foil on them.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah, and mm-hmm.
You like those, don't you?
I really, this speaks to me. I like
yeah.
the, I like the
shiplap
Douglas fir and the shiplap and yeah. Little touch of red here and there.
Yeah,
that's
very
a
fun.
That's a Betty.
Yeah. Well, I remember that one. It's time for your Christmas present.
I don't send cards anymore.
Okay. Well, it's a lot of work.
Dog on it. Yeah.
And then here's a set of cards that used some glass jars with flowers in them, and then they used a separate company altogether used them on a calendar. So it's got 12 different pieces of artwork, and that's been published 2 different years now up in Canada.
And this is by Hufford.
Yeah.
But this is for the Canadian market.
Yeah. Isn't that fun?
Wow.
Yeah. So some of the words we had to translate into French. This is the English version, but there's also
because
a French.
They do speak French in parts of Canada.
Yeah. Isn't that cool?
Well, that's
and then
very
these
cool.
were the originals. So again, the publisher that I use, they will print prints, and I'll show you an example of that. You can go to pennylanepublishing.com. So this was the original that I hand painted, and then I scanned it, and then they will print it as a print. Now, the original painting has more value because it's just one of a kind. I mean, you could print 100,000 of these if you wanted to, but only one person ever gets to have the original on their wall. So that's why it's worth a little bit more. And then
or a
if,
lot more.
There you go. Thank you, Betty.
I want to interject here that I think when you're a person is purchasing art,
sure,
whether it be the original or some iterations done from the original artwork,
sure,
I think it's just a very heartwarming thing to know something personal about the artist, because you know, I'm thinking of like Thomas Kincaid or Terry Redlin or some of the various artists that people really do like knowing a little something about them as a person, because it seems to so many of us with a lot less talent that this is just an impossible thing. How do you even make that come out of your paintbrush? So that's Cindy, what's a little secret about you, but besides the fact that you chocolate is one of your 4 food groups?
Okay. Chocolate is the only food group in my vocabulary. But I've always liked to color. In fact, I recently found my kindergarten report card.
No way.
And it said Cindy likes to color. And then about
outside the lines.
Yeah, no, I was always inside the lines. And then my first grade teacher a while back, she brought me to one of our warehouse sales a handful of little things I had made for her. I had cut out a little purse and colored it and cut out a little shoe, and she had saved them. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna cry. She had saved them all those years. So I think art is something that has just always been good therapy for me.
You it can. Is. And
for anybody.
My byline when I had my store was I would tell my customers that home is where your eyes should be the happiest. You want to make your eyes happy. So that's something that art is such a personal thing that choose it carefully, choose it slowly. Don't try to just go out and buy everything at once, and let it evolve and become part of the story of your life too.